What's good, Black Star Podcast? This is your boy Jared, and today I'm going to be talking to you guys about something that a lot of people need to understand. And Spotify, I know I've been playing around. I know, but I have an explanation. I've been doing my lives on YouTube. A lot of people have been talking to me about doing more lives, and I've been thinking about doing more lives on YouTube. So, admittedly, I've been playing around with doing more YouTube videos. So, I do apologize for that. And please, just bear with me as I'm going through a time of readjustment and trying to bring you more content. But I'm good. I'm back. And you know what, guys? We're going to jump into this one because this needs to be talked about. And this is actually something that's important for you guys to understand. German cars are meant for mechanics and car enthusiasts. And what I mean by car enthusiasts, I mean cars. Well, I mean car guys that know how to fix their own engines, build their own, rebuild their transmissions, or know exactly where to get the parts from. Because, let's face it, if you guys are looking at buying a used BMW, a used Mercedes, a used Audi, or anything that is foreign or European, it's going to cost you a hell of a lot of money. And a lot of people don't understand that. Yes, these cars are very beautiful cars. They're very beautiful. In fact, I want to get a used 7 Series. 750 LI. You know what I'm talking about. Or, I was thinking about getting a M5. Whether it be the V10 M5 or be the F01 to F02 M5. I love BMW, but I love the sedans. I hate the SUVs. But the reason why I say this is because a lot of people that buying a newer car on the market is the best thing. In some cases, yes, especially when you're looking for a German or, like I said, a European type of car. It's always best to get these cars from the factory because they have factory warranties, and these cars are covered under the warranties. But as soon as it goes outside of the warranty, it becomes a headache, a problem, and a nightmare to keep up maintenance on. And the reason why I say that is because a lot of these German to European manufacturers, they don't spend the time to actually sort out the issues with the vehicles. And they also don't spend the time to actually, they spend too much time, I should say, over engineering the vehicle. For those of you who know that BMW has their V8s. Their V8s, their current model V8s are hot V8s. So meaning, these vehicles have twin turbochargers, and the V of the actual engine itself. Now, it's good for torque, acceleration purposes too. It's good for that stuff. But the problem comes in to where you have heat built up inside of that engine, especially because the hood's solid, so it's not extracting heat. So you constantly got heat cooking the engine itself, and then you have plastic cooling lines around these engines. So what happens is, over time and heat cycles, the plastic gets brittle, and you get engine problems. You get bearing wear, throw out bearing wear out. You get a lot of stuff that wears out, especially with the constant heat cycles. Same thing with Audi. BMW and Audi had a class action lawsuit because their turbochargers kept failing. BMW had a class action lawsuit for their cars because their engines, they're especially with an early, especially with an early development of the V8s, the engines kept failing. You had time and chain, you had time and chain failures. You had valve seats failing. You had a whole bunch of shit that went on with those engines. And those engines had so many different revisions that BMW are still producing them, and they're a lot better nowadays. But still, I wouldn't trust buying a older BMW or European car, in fact, especially if I'm not a gearhead or if I'm not a mechanic. Me, I am. So I understand the points of the engines, and I'm always looking to improve shit. That's just me. But for you guys that want these luxury cars, you have to understand that these cars come with issues. These cars, especially if they're an older model car, they're going to come with their issues. It's best to buy them when they're at least 1 to 2 years old. 5 or 6 years old, you're looking at a lot of issues, especially looking at the mileage. But you can always get one of these vehicles, and you can always be willing to, if you're willing to put the time and the money into one of these cars, fine. But me, I'm a performance guy. I like speed. I like high horsepower, high torque numbers. That's just me. I like this shit. I get a pleasant thrill out of having a car that's high horsepower. Makes me happy as shit. But with gas prices, I'm not doing this shit. But let's be honest. Would you spend the time and the money on a current year car? And then you lose 40% of their, 40 to 60% of their overall value within the first 5 years? Would you? Or would you take the time and buy it cheap and spend more money and then have to deal with all the electrical gremlins? Honestly, I'm leaning towards the brand, buying brand new. But it's up to you. And financially wise, it's better to buy used. But cost effectively, it's going to be more expensive to buy used than buy it outright in full. This was a hard one, guys. I can't even tell you because I love both sides of the fence. Hell, I'm looking at, like I said, I'm looking at either a M5, V10, or fucking F01 or F02, a 750 Li, or hell, even I might even say fuck it and get me an older Mercedes S55 AMG. I like high horsepower cars. I like rare cars. Well, no, not rare. They're actually very plentiful, but still. I mean, the choice is up to you guys. And if you're willing to put the time and the money and the effort into these cars, I say do it. But just know what you're getting yourself into. And for you guys that are actually want businesses, and you want to look the part, I say buy an older vehicle. I say buy an older luxury car, because it shows that you're dedicated to. It shows that, in a sense, it shows that you're dedicated to the brand, and also shows that you're willing to put in the hard work. At least for me. You're willing to put in the hard work to keep it on the road and be the part. But I don't know. And plus, a lot of you young guys out here nowadays, you guys are wanting to flaunt all your money, all your cash, and say that you're rich. I'm gonna put this one out there, and I'm gonna put a little bug in y'all here. Stop showing people that don't give a French toast about you what you have. Just stop. After you graduate high school, you're going to lose all those friends that you had in high school. About two are going to stay in contact with you. But the rest, you're not going to remember any of them. Stop flaunting cash on IG talking about, oh, I got all the money, I got this, I got that. Because I'm going to tell you one thing. You can fly all the cash in the world on IG. But the moment you lose all that money, those friends that you're talking to, they're going to be gone. Those people are going to be gone. They're going to leave you on the side of the road, high and dry. I've seen it happen too many times, in fact. They're going to leave you high and dry, and then you're not going to give a fuck about what happened to you until you get the next bit of money. And then they'll come around again and talk about, yo, I believe you can do this. I believe you can do that. No. It's always best to have your own ass and know what you have in your wallet instead of flaunting it around to other people so that other people can give you a perceived respect. Because I guarantee you one thing, those people aren't going to respect you. Those people never will respect you. Like, there's been many times where I've said, you ain't going to know I'm rich until I tell you I'm rich. That holds true. Because you're not going to know if I have any money, not unless I tell you. And then, even then, people still might know that you got money. It's all in how you hold yourself and if you're humble about yourself. Because being humble, you're not going to flash all your cash around. If you're humble about everything that you have and about the work that it took to get to where you wanted to be, you're going to understand that flaunting around that much cash and doing all this, going to the club, throwing bands upon bands to these strippers and making them rich, you will lose all that money quick. You can blow $1 million quick as hell. You can blow $1 million faster than what you can earn it. I may not have $1 million or $100,000 in my bank, but I understand the way that finances work. And if you're financially immature and financially irresponsible, you can be on the side of the street begging for money. You can be on the top of the world. And within a few short hours, you can be on the bottom. And it can happen just like that. So are you guys willing to... Are you guys willing to lose all that money? Playing around with all these different people and flaunting around your cash and buying up expensive ass luxury cars? Or are you willing to put some money into an older luxury vehicle, drive it till the wheels fall off, and repair it and make sure the wheels go back on straight, and spend the money, keep it on the road, and it costs less in the long run to you? You tell me, why are you willing to just go out here and just spend all your money on something expensive and it loses its wealth real fucking fast? Everything that I say on my podcast is not meant to discourage you or is not meant to hurt you guys' feelings. Because best believe, there's a lot of stuff that I could say, but I'm not. Because I care about you guys and I want to build you guys up. But anyways, guys, please like, share, subscribe to the YouTube channel. Also, please share the podcast because I will be doing more content on this podcast. I know I've been saying it for the past couple of weeks, but I do mean that. I am going to be making more content for this podcast because this podcast is about to become my bread and butter for right now. And then when I transfer over to building my corporate business, whether that being in Blackstar Computers or the other name that I'm thinking about, whether it be Titus, whether that be coming up with a whole bunch of things so that I can improve this world. Like I said, this YouTube channel and this podcast, it's the view into me becoming the best version of myself. And for you guys to be coming along with me and for you guys to be supporting me, I thank you guys for that. Well, anyways, guys, that's going to be it for this podcast episode. And I'll see you guys on the flip side. And thank you guys for listening to this podcast episode. And I will see you guys on the flip side. And guys, please like, share, subscribe to the YouTube channel. Also, please rate this podcast and also share this podcast with a whole bunch of other people so that my message can get out there further. But thank you guys for listening. I'll see you guys on the flip side. Bye, guys.